Hello, Windows Universe. In this video, we will talk about how to fix VPN Error 800 on Windows. For a more in-depth look at the topic, we will link an article in the description down below. Troubleshoot your network. Sometimes having a VPN error could also mean that there's some error which needs to be fixed by simply troubleshooting. Select Start, go to Settings. On Update and Security, go to Troubleshoot. Click on Additional Troubleshooting, look for, click on Network Adapter, and run the troubleshooter. Also run the Incoming Connections one. Also run Internet Connections, run the troubleshooter, follow any on-screen prompts. After running these troubleshooters, restart your system and see if the problem is corrected. VPN Error 800 can occur when your computer is infected with a virus or some kind of malicious software. Here, running your antivirus scan can help greatly. You can use Windows Defender or any aftermarket antivirus software for this. Cross-check that the VPN server address, the username, and the password are correct. Go to Settings, go to Network and Internet, look for VPN. In the pop-up that opens, check if the IP address, the username, and password are correct. Modify if you find any discrepancies and try once again. Ensure that the server name or address does not include http://. If either of the symbols is placed in the third box, it will show this error. Check your firewall and router and make sure that it isn't interfering with your VPN connection. Check the connection between the client and the VPN server to check to see if there are any network issues. Due to connection between the client and the VPN server, you'll have to ping the server and wait for a response. To do this, open a command prompt with admin privileges, type in ping, and the address you want to ping in this case. You should monitor how long it takes for the server to respond. Retrying the connection after waiting for a minute or two sometimes work with erratic network outages. Also, try the connection from a different client device that can also help decide whether or not the connectivity issue is unique to one system or if it's a network-wide common problem. If the problem persists, do not hesitate to check with your internet service provider. It could be the case that your ISP has blocked that particular GRE protocol. For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.